Excuse me, I'm looking for Dr. Matt Kendra. Could you tell me if he's checked in? Well, that was rude. Stay the hell out of my life. Haven't you done enough to hurt my family? Why can't you just leave us the hell alone? I happen to care about Lucky too much to watch you trick him into another reunion that he doesn't even want.
You're the one who put all of this in motion. You've done everything you can to undermine my marriage, and now Lucky and I are still dealing with the fallout.
Okay, first of all, you and Lucky are over. There is no you and Lucky, Elizabeth, and that's your fault because you cheated on Lucky, first with Jason and then with Lucky's own brother.
Okay, this is none of your damn business.
Oh, yeah? Well, it kind of became my business when you walked up in here and you slapped me across the face because I told Lucky the truth.
No. You did everything you can. You went out of your way to turn him
against me. You checked yourself into Shadybrook for a crisis that you weren't even having. It's pathetic. And, you know, really, it's quite cruel when you consider the fact that Lucky's own mother was a legitimate mental patient. You make him miserable, Elizabeth. Okay? Just let him go.
Oh, wait. You're not trying to protect Lucky. You just want revenge because Matt and I have become friends.
You always have a backup plan, don't you? So when Lucky fails to hang on to you, you're just going to move in on Matt?
Okay, does it bother you that I can actually comprehend what Matt says? Because if you feel insecure about it, maybe you should find somebody else to take this out on. Leave me the hell alone.
Yeah, what is going on here?
Nothing new. She's just trying to sabotage my life.
Oh, it's not my fault that Lucky happened to walk in and hear the truth that you faked that breakdown.
Really?
Prove it. I don't have to prove it. You admitted it to Matt.
You told her? You know how Maxie feels about me. You knew she would run straight to Lucky.
Well, why'd you even go to Matt and start bragging about your fake breakdown anyway?
She wasn't bragging. I never said anything about bragging.
I trusted you.
And I was upset when I realized what you were doing, not so much to Lucky, but to yourself.
Oh, you mean tricking Lucky back into a relationship that she trashed in the first place?
You were guilting Lucky back into a relationship, and I knew that was a relationship built to fail.
So you decided to give it a little push and send my family crashing down?
I went to speak with Lucky face to face, and I told him what I felt and how I didn't think it was a good idea.
You know, what are you even doing here, Elizabeth? Did you seriously think that you could come to work after the day you uncommitted yourself?
I don't owe you an explanation.
You should be at home, right? Working on Lucky? I mean, I bet if you used those tears that you pull out so well and you told him that you were really, really sorry and that you were just confused and desperate, you'd be able to reel him back in. I mean, you were so good at your little victim and martyr.
Okay, all right. You know what? That's enough.
I'm not going to apologize for trying to hold my family together.
Oh, dress it up all you want. You still lie.
Okay, look, she has been through so much lately, including nearly dying of pneumonia.
No,
she certainly did not fake
Lucky's
any of that.
Guilt to trap him.
No, look, if I may, she was trying to keep her family together, her kids with their father. And as someone who grew up without a parent, that's certainly something that I can appreciate, although not the method.
Well, she slapped me. Are you implying that I deserved it?
Don't ask questions. You can't handle the answers.
You deserve to lose Lucky, and I hope that someday, when the kids ask him why he had to bail, he tells them the truth. He couldn't live with you.
Oh, Maxie, stop this.
No. This is good. This is good for you to see just how hateful she really is.
At least I'm honest. I don't have to act like a victim to get what I want.
Okay, we need to talk away from her, but right now I need to go get my paycheck and then just go home to my kids.
Yeah, hurry home. Take that last shot at manipulating Lucky.
See, all right, look.
You know,
listen,
no,
before you...
Not another word out of you or I'll slap you.
Maxie, listen.
You know, you are so lucky that I couldn't find Robin because I planned on telling her all about how you dissed me to suck up to Elizabeth. And believe me, Robin would have taken my side because some people know the meaning of loyalty.
Lower your voice, okay? I was not
siding with Elizabeth. Excuse me, I'm trying to text my cousin.
I don't think that you deserve to be slapped, okay?
That's funny because you could have said something when Elizabeth was standing right there.
Look, she's going through so much right now, okay? I feel very bad for her.
No, great, Matt. Sympathize with Elizabeth all you want.
Listen, can you listen to me? It's almost Christmas. I don't want us to be like this.
Yeah, we should have thought about that before you drop-kicked me in front of Elizabeth.
Can I tell you something? Christmas is my favorite time of year. I don't want that to be ruined by us fighting, okay?
You know, when I was little, I used to love Christmas so much. But then for a while, my sister died, and after that, I don't know, I started to hate it.
Okay. How about now?
I guess I'm learning to love it again. I mean, I know it's crazy commercialized, but it is all about tradition and reconnecting family. And I helped Mac pick out all these ornaments, and they're pretty awful, but he loves them.
Are they too colorful?
Let's just say that Emma told him that his entire apartment looks and sounds like the North Pole.
Sounds?
Yeah, he always insists on playing all these Christmas carols, and he wants to read The Night Before Christmas all the time.
Okay. So I have the entire Christmas thing. What is your favorite part?
I'd have to say waking up Christmas morning and having that feeling like I did when I was a child, believing that there's still magic in the world.
Okay. Well, you want to hear my Christmas wish?
Sure.
Just that I want to spend it with you.
Myself on that?
No, not until you promise you will celebrate Christmas with me.
Well, it won't be much of a Christmas if I lose my job.
Because
then
day,
I won't
actually.
Be able to buy presents or Matt, come on, give me my phone.
Okay, fine. Under one condition. Can you meet my condition?
Maybe.
That is, you have to at least consider spending Christmas with me.
Well, that depends if you have a high tolerance for Christmas carols and awful decorations.
No problem. There's no problem. I can do that.
Never mind, Elizabeth's back. You know, she looks really sad. She could probably use your sympathy. Just please remember, she's only trying to use you, same way she did with Lucky.